Let's take a trip back in time. When I was younger and more naive, I loved getting asked, "What kind of superpower would you want?" And my answer was always to go back in time. Not because I love the movie The Butterfly Effect, or because I'm obsessed with Life is Strange, but it's for a different reason. Reason that heavily influenced my positive thinking and changed the way I view the world we live in.
Glad we can all get together for the hike.
Same here. Thank you guys for coming along. The more I ponder about it, the more I realize that this hike to Stevenson Falls really was a way for me to become grateful for the littlest things in life, allowing myself to have a deterministic mindset, accepting struggles in my life, and really living in these special moments. That's a mistake I made countless times. And I'm running through these walls. I don't even know if I believe. Growing up, I would make a lot of mistakes that led me to getting in trouble by my parents. And having the power to go back in time just helped, knowing that I could never mess up again. However, the more you think about it, it's the little mistakes in the past as well as the major ones that make us who we are. We all wish things could be different, but everything happens for a reason. The people you meet, the goals you're achieving, it might not have been possible if you hadn't made a certain mistake in the past. If I were to be asked that question now, I'd still choose to go back in time. But instead of redoing my mistakes, I would instead love to sit down with my past self and tell him how great he is doing. It's encouraging, just like exploring new places with your friends.
Oh, look at this. This is so cool.
Bro.
I always struggled with believing myself and was hardly ever convinced I had a real purpose or meaning in life. But accepting who you are, being grateful, and understanding that worrying about what other people think of you is a curse only you can break free from.
Yeah.
Hey.
Don't let people put labels on you and depict who you should be. Be your own person. Do what you want to do because you love it and not to please others. Hang out with the friends you enjoy being around, not because you're forced to. Embracing these hardships will be the best thing that's ever happened to you. And as I work on this, I'm slowly realizing how much happier I can be without the extreme amount of overthinking that fulfills my mind on a daily basis. Surround yourself with positivity. The goal at the end of this hike was to reach the waterfall, which seemed like it was taking an eternity to get to. It didn't stop us from letting our inner child out.
Bro.
Shaggy had the great idea of creating paper airplanes. It's Tito against water. Let's go. How you feel, Shag?
So great. I've had three beers on the way up.
Very energized. Who do you think's the most exhausted? You good?
Where's the waterfall? I'm running. Dude.
Even though I have plans to move to Oregon in a year or two, I'm glad I'm taking the time to appreciate I have while I'm still here in California. One thing that really stuck with me ever since I started my long-term plan to move was said by my buddy Christian. You don't want to live a life full of regret. Take the time to hang out with those you care about. That way you aren't wishing you had a little more time. I was so focused on the future that I wasn't living in the present, a hardship I'm still learning to adjust to. Because after all, there's a reason it's called the present. It's a moment that is to be appreciated and given your full attention. That's what makes it so special.
Through the blizzard.